for watching Medfield TV Community Shows.
Good afternoon and welcome. This is Ned Hackett and Mike Rimmel and Erica Sell from Medfield TV doing our first broadcast of the 2016 Medfield Girls Soccer Season.
How you doing, man? How you doing, Eric?
Good.
Here on the brand new turf field with the resplendent Big M and the proper Medfield colors. Medfield in their home whites going left to right, playing the visiting Millis Mohawks going right to left. So this is the first year we don't have any kids in the program, so we have no inside
scoop. We have no money in the game here.
So we have rumor from the coach is he's got high hopes, good expectations for this season. We see how they play, and if that'll work out. So
we got a formation here, man.
So this year, we're going to play a flat three defense, five midfielders, and two strikers. So we'll work our way through the numbers. So there's going to be a lot of action in the midfield. And according to the inside scoop, we'll have an offensive midfielder and a defensive midfielder. So when the play shifts, you have another offensive player or another defensive player. So, so we'll work around the back line. Number nine, right in the middle.
That's Grace. Grace Terry.
Grace Terry. Well, actually, that's Grace Terry on the outside. Number three, Lauren Casseri is senior captain, right playing center fullback or center defense. KG, so defense will be Terry, Casseri, and Petit across the back, I believe. And so that would be so Grace Terry, number nine, closest to us, Casseri in the middle, and then Petit on the far side. And then we'll start with the easy ones up top, the strikers, Cooney and Sherman. So I'll try to recognize them. So that's the easy part. And then the midfield,
we've got five of them,
so it'll take us a little longer to work that out. And we got to recognize the ponytails and the headbands and the numbers.
Yeah, we don't have any special colored cleats this year.
We don't have the fluorescent out, right? Cleats to help us out. So we're midfield. Ooh, we like that. So right across the middle, KG, number 30. So we can KG with the knee brace. Hopefully that's not a long-term issue. So we the captains this year are KG, Captain Giordano, number 30. And then Lauren Casseri, number 3. And then, unfortunately, the other captain, Sydney Jolie, number 19, is on the injured list with a broken elbow.
Yes.
So she'll be missed for 5 weeks or so, but hopefully she'll heal properly and get ready for tournament time. So
it doesn't take her too long to get back in this way. She's got a force in the back there.
So Millis making a little bit of a charge. Casseri's there to clean up. KG working it.
To finish up the starters, we got Phipps, we got Hurley, we got McCarthy, and Chin.
Yeah, so Maggie and McCarthy, number 21.
And
who's been
KG, and that's our five.
So KG closest to us, number 30. Maggie McCarthy, number 21.
Cooney.
And Cooney with the head.
That's up to Sherman. Nice first touch.
To Taylor Sherman. Oh, puts it in right there. So,
done.
So, we finally got her number right. So
just in time,
about
too.
4 minutes in. Taylor Sherman puts it on the board.
Just in time.
Nice play. So, hopefully that's a harbinger of the rest of the season.
Right on.
So, an exciting schedule this year, Mike. We've got the big date at Gillette Stadium.
Yeah, that's going to be fun. That's going to be against Medway, too.
So against Medway.
Be, a good time.
So well, I don't know who's the force to be in the Tri-Valley League this year.
That's
nice through ball.
But most times it's Medfield, BS, and Medway, right?
Correct. So we forgot to mention Sarah Graham's in goal. She's been a stalwart goalie for the last three seasons.
Awesome.
So Medfield... dropping back. Lights are on. Clouds are coming in. I don't think it's going to rain, but it's nice, comfortable.
It's a beautiful day.
Mid-70s,
yeah. Not a lot of wind.
So it looks like they're going to put some netting up around the back for...
Yeah, that's the deal.
That's the plan.
I guess we're doing a new tractor as well, so...
Okay.
I think what will happen is we're just some... We have a couple home games, and then they go on the road, and when they go on the road, I understand they're hooked to track. That's the game.
Very good. Because there is a... Medfield does have a funny... Like a five-game stretch there on the road.
Yeah, and even those games at home that are...
I know they do have one at Wheelock, but I'm not sure if that's definitive. So number seven is Alana Cooney. Is the other Ford with the ponytail. So we'll have to get her on the radar.
Yes.
And then Casey Chin. Let's see if I can remember what number she is. She's number
34.
She's she played quite well last year.
Yep.
KG flipping it forward to Sherman. Sherman nicely done.
A nice ball.
Oh, the call offside. So, properly positioned, so can't argue with that call, can we, Mike?
Right. So has offsides changed over the years, Matt? I know we've been doing this a while now, and I know you like talking about it.
I don't, offsides is offsides, but you can't be behind the last defender before the ball is played.
That's the key,
right? Depending on the position of the referee, so usually it's nice with two refs working both sides, so hopefully they can get that call correct. We've run into issues in the past. There we go. So hopefully not so much.
It's a tough play offsides because as an offensive player, you always want to have that edge. You know?
So Cooney making chase. Ooh, she's got some speed.
Oh, she does, yep.
And slides in. It's a post. KG tries to get there, but Cooney picked up some serious yardage on that ball. Hit the post, nicely placed to the far post. So offense seems to be working nicely. It seems like they're cycling the midfielders to help out the two strikers quite easily. Yep. So it seems to be working out nicely. And I've noticed that Kisiri, she snuck up here and was in the midfield, and one of the midfielders went back to cover her position. So there seems to be opportunistic type of setup.
You take it when they give it to you, right?
Exactly.
You know, it's funny. Millis is like two different teams, and you play them here on the turf, and
they play it on their grass.
Field, right?
Exactly.
I don't know if you remember.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I know it might have been a wild field, but boy, that's a tough field.
It's a tough field, and they had a really good squad. I think 4 or 5 years ago, they won the D3 state title, and they were very good.
They always were competitive.
And they gave us a run before, I think they won the state title before we did. Maybe it was 2005 or something. But KG making a play, McCarthy right behind her. Chin looking to do something, but
But you're right. You made a nice point in the fact that midfield is keeping their shape very nicely.
Yeah, and I think I was explaining.
Now we have our work cut out for us because it's 7-8. So.
Okay, you've got the better vision.
I got my glasses on, so I'm thinking. So
we need. I think that's we met.
Yeah.
Number 26. Maybe no.
Well, Wimette did come on the pitch.
Okay, so she's...
And I think it's Tim Nemorowski on the far side left.
Okay.
Again, we have to get different pieces of headbands because this just isn't fair for us.
Yeah, and then if they have that flowing hair styles, we can't see what their numbers are. So Nemorowski would be number 5.
Yes.
If we can...
Yes, I believe she's...
Okay.
She's listed as a midfield, which means she's helping out up top.
So I would imagine they're probably going to do a lot of subbing in the midfield because they're covering essentially 80% of the field from between the 20s. So,
yes.
So McCarthy stays put. We met number 26 right beside her. So that's a good pairing. And then Keiichi on the outside. McCarthy coming in.
So what are we counting? 19 on the roster this year?
19 on the roster. And only one freshman, Sophia Gustafson. Another legacy player, is that how we call it?
Can't wait to see her play.
Her older sister, Christine, was
a lot of fun to watch, right?
Yeah, oh, nice, almost squeaks it through. McCarthy trying to make a play. So, Grace Terry is moving back to the back line. Nice throw in. She'll see a lot of action. Nice soft ball down to the wing to.
That's Sam
Nemirovsky switching outside. Seems these forwards have the ability to move left to right and in and out. McCarthy looking to put a left foot on frame. So we played 10 minutes. Medfield up 1-0 by an early score by Kayla Sherman.
It's been all Medfield pretty much, wouldn't you say? 60,
I don't think Medfield had one goal kick. So Millis is able to come down their territory once. Kasseri over to Grace Terry. Looking to play it up to KJ.
I think the ship has been great.
Well, what's going to happen is I think a lot of teams are going to find it very hard to move the ball through the midfield. If Medfield keeps their shape, and you have to have some nice pinpoint 1-2-3 passing to work it through the midfield.
Or over the top.
But you've got Kasseri and some height in the back, yeah. And hopefully they can head it right back in. So we'll see how it does have its advantages. Because usually if you control the midfield, you can control the play. And a lot of times you don't have to score 5 goals. You can score 1 or 2 and then control the midfield and not give up any serious chances.
And this time by Hurley.
So Hurley with the headband coming up. We met. Nice outside to McCarthy. McCarthy, a perennial Clare Valley All-Star basketball player also, lacrosse player. Ooh. Nice. There we go, just get those quick feet. I think she's probably on Dancing with the Stars next season too. But Grace Terry. Now, we need to assume that Kasseri will take the long throw-ins. Is she taking a long throw-in in the offensive zone?
She and Petit both have.
We'll keep an eye on that.
Petit has a nice throw-in as well.
Okay.
So, covered.
We'll see, because that can be a nice set piece.
Sure. So we got a sub coming in.
Okay, that would be number...
Is that Cooney?
Cooney coming back in.
Yes.
So... Okay, so Numerowski stays in on the far side. KG sneaking up on an outside midfielder on the far post. Cooney in the middle. McCarthy sneaking up. And Remet is still in there, Sophia. So says that Petit took that throw in?
That was Petit, yeah.
Okay, good.
So
we got three on three. Yeah. Nice touch. Medfield getting back. Slows down the flow for Millis.
That's to your point, man, we just said before with the minis coming back.
You got it. Now Medfield's got some white shirt. Sarah Graham on the first hop.
So on that one, Hurley was the first one back of the midfield. So
there you go.
That's your diamond, right?
That's your, got to get back and clean up to the point of attack. So Eric must be glad that summer's over. He's going to start broadcasting football games and field hockey games and soccer games.
Girls soccer then.
I'm
not saying.
He can only work on his hands for so long before he's going to get behind the lens again. He's not playing either.
So they have the boys' football start has an opener on
Friday.
Thank you. Right, you have Millis keeper coming out. We have a name for the Millis keeper, don't we? Flip the sheet over.
There you go.
So once again, Medfield coached by Mike LaFrancesca. And the shorts on the five sidelines. And Melinda Lohan, usual assistant coach, is a volunteer coach this year. So
congratulations to Lohans on the baby. The baby over the summer.
Excellent. So that's always good news.
Chrissy was sending me some snaps of her. And she already had her in a Medfield blue
the T-shirt hoodie and all that sort of stuff.
There you go.
There you go. So was that Petit with a long throw?
That's a good
ball. Over the top. All good. So goal kick for Millis. We're about almost 15 minutes in. 40-minute halves in the Tri-Valley League soccer. So Medfield up by one. Medfield in their home whites.
And they're allowed to call timeouts in high school soccer, right?
Is it one per half? Something like that. And Morawski looking at, that's Gustafson, number two. Is it on the far side? See if that's a two or a five.
Can I wait till she runs? I think you're right.
I think that's two. That's Sophia Gustafson getting action. Number two. Oh, a little bump on the back. They get away. No call on that.
No, you did. One foul. That's pretty good. Again, really good play.
McCarthy looking to play it outside, but that gets snuffed. Millis on the charge, but McCarthy. That's what I like about Medfield defense. She's offside. Is she going to touch it? Oh, they're going to get away. So Cooney. Oh. Skips it in. Got a nice little, well placed, right under the goalie's outset hand, but
nice job.
So Medfield goes up by two with a nice little soft through ball.
That's a nice pass by McCarthy.
Very nice.
Nice touch on that ball.
And off to a good start.
Here we go. Timeout,
Millis. So we'll let them have a timeout. We'll pick up the action when this timeout's over. And we're back after Medfield, going up by a score 2-0. Courtesy of
Cooney. You got KG, you got Cooney, you got Gustafson, you got Morawski, then you got McCarthy, you got Lamette, you got Terry, you got Greeley.
Keep going.
Yeah.
You're doing well.
Kasseri.
Grace Terry.
That
should be.
Is that Shane?
Let's see. Abby Cross. Is that number 12?
Abby.
Abby Cross, number 12, getting some action.
Sorry, she had an older sister, Shatter, crapped in last year.
So we have to.
That's awesome.
Yeah, so.
That's great. Everyone's in.
Well, get them.
I think that's awesome.
Learn the new system, so I would assume they've had a couple of scrimmages.
They have.
But it's always good to play. So Kasseri coming up from this throw-in. Near post, defended out. Medfield will get a corner kick out of that, which we like. So we'll see what... So KG will be the near side corner kicker. And favorite target usually is we met in Maggie McCarthy. Yeah. So McCarthy's gone far post, Medfield clustering near post, KG sends it far, looking to, McCarthy able to get ahead on it. So that's, I think the play on that one is they cluster everybody far and try to get right over their heads and McCarthy can get ahead on it. So it's like a pick play with everybody, but we'll see if, maybe they should call that Omaha, or something like that.
Yeah, you can miss him this year or what?
So McCarthy coming up the midfield, follows the play. So Gustafson is in the play.
It's cross, nice play.
Ella, where did Izzy go?
It's hard.
If we need to,
that's Abby Cross. Yeah.
We'll be up to speed by time, don't you think?
We got it, because these guys are going to go a little way this year. I have a feeling.
Good go. When we do our post-game interviews, we'll find out who the powerhouse to be.
Yeah.
And see if Dover Sherburn. We would assume Dover Sherburn and
Medway. It's probably Diaz Medway, but Diaz and Medway both graduated a lot of seniors last year.
Yeah.
That always bodes well for, and this class has a lot of seniors,
Maybe
I think he's going to be in good shape. I'm predicting him to win the TVL. I'll tell you right now,
This is
putting it out there, first thing, Eric.
You know what you say on, this is live stream, so what you say just will stay out there forever.
I'm good with it.
Okay.
I feel strongly that this team has good talent, good leadership.
Good. Cooney, doing a nice job boxing out. He was able to turn. KG trying to get the help out. Millis playing it to the back line. Looking to squeak it through. Kasiri. So I think when they play the three back, they have Kasiri as kind of a bit of a triangle. So it's not like a flat three.
So
but
it's
they
not
have,
fun anymore to have a sweeper?
Yeah, it's
sweeper stopper.
Sweeper stopper, so they're not susceptible to those through diagonal balls.
Right, because there's nothing worse than that.
There's nothing, especially when you only got three, with a quick transition with three defenders, you don't have someone back to mop it up. So we'll see how that works out.
Kasiri. About halfway through the first, it's 2-0 Medfield. Anything special?
It's just the weather's great. The camera work is awesome.
Yes, camera work is always awesome.
It seems that no rain showers are going to come. The lights are on. The field is great.
It's a great time of year.
It's a great day to...
I was driving in today to the field, and did you know that the Bowling Brook's closed?
They close, Labor Day?
What's up with that? I was going to go after the game. I love that place.
Well, you got to keep it local. You can go to the new local Medfield establishment.
We have a couple new ones.
That's right.
Have you been there yet?
Yes, I have, but I can't,
can't on air?
I can't, I can't show favorites.
Maybe for a small fee.
I can't do that. Downtown Medfield's like downtown Medford. It's like hip and happening. KG, mate, running off. She's got, help.
That was a good try by KG.
So that's it. Who's that on the far side? Is that Annie Phipps?
Yes, it is.
With the knee brace?
It is.
Okay.
Last season, broader ACL, unfortunately.
That's probably a preventative
it
brace?
It is, as is KG. Unfortunately, with that last year.
Well, the thing about women, nice give and go, is female athletes are more prone to ACL injuries than the boys are. And that's...
It's crazy.
It's a crazy thing, but it's nice to... You don't want to end your high school career and limp through the rest of your life, so to have the braces is good protocol, as is the concussion protocol that Medfield has in place and all TVL teams have.
Girls soccer is right the second hit with most of the concussion.
Yeah,
right?
Exactly. So Sarah Graham in goal has seen... Has she made? I don't think she won save. Okay, so the back line, Kasiri in the middle, Grace Terry close to us, number 9. And the defender on the far side, is that still Abby Cross, number 12?
Yes, it is.
Sneaks through, and I, whoa! Millis almost had a little touch goal, but Sarah Graham able to pick it up and thwart that attempt.
So. I always feel like the best teams in the town are the ones who have more experienced players.
More seniors, yeah.
So this team has 10 seniors.
10 seniors.
7 juniors.
Yeah.
1 sophomore and 1 freshman.
So that bodes well. Exactly.
I think that's going to help them out.
And a lot of returning starters KG started, Sherman started, McCarthy started, Phipps started, Terry started, Kasiri started. So, just that dish and Sarah Graham. So, 8-9 returning starters. Oh, this could be trouble. Oh!
Nice. Nice play by Green.
Nice hustle, but not give up on that ball. So
that's always a scary place, because if that player goes down and Grace is down.
Well, the thing about defense is you have to be a very good player to play defense.
I totally agree.
And you know, if you make a mistake on defense, everybody sees it. Right. You make a mistake on offense, you shoot it over the goal, you get another try. But defense, you have to be spot on.
To your point, you can't have a bad touch.
You can't have a bad touch, and you have to make 90% of the time. You have to make a good decision.
Everybody knows.
Yeah, exactly.
Because most times it's a goal.
So Grace Terry, good hustle, good recovery.
And Sarah coming off a line.
Yeah, so, awesome job. It's, you know, you have to have good communication. So what's nice about, you know, the three defenders on the goalie, you have to be very familiar with who can do what and when they're going to come out and when I'm going to take the ball. So
very good play.
So hopefully that back line on the goalie will gel nicely and keep that goose egg on the board for this game and the following games. So is that
Chin,
number 34?
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So he has a good motor from last year. I remember she was a spark plug whenever she came in, something good happened. Taylor Sherman working the line.
They're
going to call that, but going for the ball, but a foul nonetheless. Free kick for Millis around the 50. That's a nice feel.
Yes, it's very nice.
So
the best our money could buy.
I heard that you got some of the old turf and you did your front yard and you did
turf, because yard work.
Yes.
You don't want to do it anymore.
I don't. It grows too much. Yeah.
So it's
plus,
good.
There's a watering ban on, so it really did.
You have the greenest yard in town.
I do.
See, that's smart.
It worked out well. My only problem with the new turf was Chrissy Wishy was playing on his field, because last year's field was a bit choppy.
Well, I remember when my son was a senior, they played one of the first games on the brand new turf. It didn't have lines. It didn't have numbers.
No way.
Oh, yes. And they just put the rubber chips
on. How did it play?
Yeah, well, they had the outside lines, but they didn't have any of the other lines.
And the boxes marked
them. And the rubber was flying everywhere because it hadn't embedded itself just yet. And it was a rainy day, so they came out. I think they took a lot of rubber home with them.
That was the technology. How many years ago was that? 10, 11, 12?
Yeah, that was...
Now they use sand, right? That's my understanding. Is it sand?
We'll see what's up.
Yeah,
we'll have to take a up close. Maybe that would be a good segment for Medfield TV to do it up close.
I think Eric should do
how it's made segment on the Medfield turf field.
Yeah. Well, I know the biggest thing, they increased the drainage under the under the turf. So that was the first thing, is get the water off. So.
But you think of once these fields go in. You know, 10 or 12 years, you don't have to fertilize. You don't have to worry about dandelions. You don't have to worry about some kid driving his car.
And how often they're used.
Yep, and 24/7 they could use this. In the wintertime, they just shovel up. You could have winter league. So
Millis connecting the ball nicely the last 5 minutes there. I mean, this is very good for Millis. Nice turn.
Yeah. Chin making a play. Annie Phipps on the far side, trying to close things down. Cross right there.
Nice, nice tackle.
Very McCarthy nice heading tackle. It forward. Nobody home to receive that. So Kayla Sherman as the up top striker, number 22. KG outside midfielder looking for some action. Cooney on the far side. So...
So basically, Cooney and KG stay up high, I noticed.
Stay up high, exactly. Unless they have need help defensively, because Grace Terry is picking up the outside forward for Millis.
It's Cooney.
So, it's kind of interesting to see how they spot the offensive players on Millis defensively when they come down, when they transition. See who's responsible for what. Millis, nice trap.
Did your son win his game?
No, it was against Norton. I think they got beat up.
Norton has a good team.
Norton
boys
is a,
team.
They're always, very large. They were a tall squad. Yeah. So Millis gets a throw in Medfield territory.
Right, so we got a little bunch. 11 minutes left to go. It's 2-0 Medfield. You had Sherman score and Cooney score. It's been pretty much, other than that one
little left. But it's kind of nice to get some, you know, you need some action in the back.
Oh, I agree.
I would assume the first couple of games are going
to
be
to figure
a learning
out
experience.
Right.
And so work some players out.
I don't have the schedule in front of me, but I know they play DS maybe the fourth game of the season in DS. So
in
that's
DS,
always a good game.
Kasiri with the goal kick looking to go far post. Cooney heads it forward. No.
That's Cooney.
Alana playing it on the sideline. Oh, Medfield doesn't get the benefit of that call. Millis with a switch. Doing the Premier League jersey in, jersey out switching.
That's a good deal because most times I'd wound up with 10 or 12 people on the field, so I'm glad they do that.
I've got two jerseys.
That always works. Nice throw in.
Nicely defended by Medfield. KG looking to play it through to Sherman. Sherman with a nice touch and turn. Millis on the transition. Terry's going to take care of that. McCarthy's going to look to play over the top to Sherman.
Ball. Yeah,
Sherman's got a little bit of territory.
Takes a fall,
and it got in the whistle. Yeah. But we'll take that. Oh, we'll take that.
What is that? Is that a foul?
Yeah.
Wow.
Sherman got called for the trip.
What trip?
Well, didn't you see the Millis player fall down?
No. Well, I saw a girl stick a leg out to try to trip her. And
well, I'm just making an assumption.
Do you want my glasses?
They're too fashionable for me. You must get those online from an online retailer.
Eric, we've been doing this for a while now. Have we ever agreed on the officiating?
No.
Wait a minute, so the call is going, so...
See?
Medfield
there
gets the
go.
Call.
There you go, he agreed with me.
So we finally, because it seems like... But the foul wasn't... Maybe they did a play on.
Oh, continuation.
Continuation,
that's what it must have been.
And then they got the foul. When
I apologize.
The trip when... Oh.
I apologize for everything I was thinking then.
To clarify, there's a foul. If that occurs, the referee can call, uses their discretion to call the foul then, or if the player still has an advantage, they'll call the continuation.
Yep.
And then once the play stops,
which
the
is
foul
right.
is called in Medfield,
right.
and the they get the play. That's why McCarthy got tripped, or almost tripped. She got slowed down, but she was able to get around the Millis defender and continue the play. So continuation. Then the play got terminated. Medfield got the call.
I apologize for everything I was thinking about.
No, I think because I was confused too momentarily.
Nice play there. Nice play by Sherman.
Sherman coming back, looking for help in the back line with McCarthy.
Nice
and you can do a lot of bumping. You can do a lot of shoulder checking, which as long as you keep your hands in your pockets, you can do anything you want with your shoulders. So Medfield, always known for tenacious ball hawking. Isn't that what you call it, Mike?
I do, and you're right. Take that space away from them.
And when most teams realize they have like one touch before a defender's, that's a foul right there.
Oh, my.
So we'll call that one. So, good sportsmanship on there.
That was Fipsy gone down. So, that's the fourth penalty of the game. Two each. That's not bad.
Not bad. So the referee's letting him play. So we have 7.5 minutes to play in the first half of first home game. First
game
of the season.
Yeah, good quality.
Medfield up 2. Sherman and Cooney with kind of sneaking in 1-on-1, pushing it home.
And finishing nicely.
McCarthy protecting the midfield. Frost coming up. Grace Terry.
Nice pool.
But can't make it through Maggie Hurley. She must have gotten the ball first.
Yeah, that's always a tough one.
If you get the ball first, you can hit the player second. Millis making a concerted effort.
Medfield remaining very composed on that one. Just keeping their calm,
keeping
kick
their
it
calm.
out. But you're right about that, the McCarthy tackle. I think you're right. She got the ball first. Here we got some subs.
So we get some subs. So that I would assume.
I'm guessing that's Wimet.
Wimet with the sleeves rolled
and
up.
And that's Petit.
Okay. So Petit in for Kraus.
And Nemirovsky. So you had three in, three out.
Okay. So Nemirovsky.
So Sam is the number five on the far side.
Boy, it's Nemirovsky and Gustafsson.
They do.
They're almost identical.
They do. Gustafsson has a bow in her hair.
Okay. Well, that doesn't have. I need a bigger bow. So that's going to roll out for... Nope, Millis keeps it alive.
Nice play. Oh, that's a great comeback by
Maggie,
Hurley.
Hurley able to defend that.
Maggie's done a great job there.
That's going to clip out, and that's going to go for a goal kick. So it looks like Kasseri's going to take all the goal kicks.
Yeah.
From the back.
You know, that's funny.
Which makes sense. Yeah. So you get your two defenders move up out of the penalty area.
Right.
That big orange.
But that
box.
gives Millis the that final third, right?
It's a absolutely.
If we're taking the goal kick, right?
Yeah.
Normally it's the goalie, and you get that third.
Millis with a little off the senses surge, ooh. But
Nemirovsky jumped in there beautifully.
The end.
Again, to your point, the middies are coming back beautifully.
Middies are coming back, yeah. So it seems.
So it's making coach look very brilliant.
Well, a lot of times you kind of have to make a formation with the character of your players, because you really can't force a certain formation on players who aren't able to execute
it's
it.
True.
So apparently he's seen something in his players. And a long distance up and over by Millis. So,
yeah, but you're right with Kasseri. She's playing.
And what's nice about that, if you can defend with three, that gives you a little more offensive punch.
Yeah.
So
I think to your point, too, is that they're winning the ball in the midfield,
which
we both know that controls the game.
It's very disruptive to, try to, get, when you try to move the ball through the midfield and you just can't do it. And then if you start doing the kick and run, that's usually not successful unless you've got a real jet runner on
right.
the outside that can, but so far so good. That's going to squeak down. I think Millis touched that, so
I
she has
too,
to play
yeah.
it. Oh, is that Sherman right there?
Yeah, yes.
Sherman going left to right, which we like to see. Working the width of the field. Petit on the throw-in.
Oh, nice throw.
Is that sneaking through to... Oh!
Alley, that's a great throw by Alley.
So, Sophia Wimet almost got a nice touch on that one.
It's Kasseri.
Kasseri. Able to almost turn that one, but it goes over to Allison Petit, whose older sister, Lauren, was a...
Good athlete.
Stalwart defender for Medfield and also a great basketball player.
Still is. In Bowdoin, yeah. She's playing
there
well.
There you go. See, you're my conduit, Mike.
Yeah, she's good. Great athlete.
It's going to go up for a Millis
Medfield
throw.
Medfield has a lot of good athletes. So that's
Medfield is...
it's easy to say that.
A good town, good school system.
Yep.
Good athletic program. Well-rounded kids come from Medfield. 100% graduation rate at the high school.
Is that right?
Absolutely. I just read it the other day.
Wow.
So
that's impressive.
3 minutes left in the first half.
And we have the newest field in the Tri-Valley.
And that's bragging rights over the big M. You can't miss that from the Skylab.
Oh, nice
flies
move.
Over. They know where that goes.
And Sherman, I
Sherman
think.
Looking for KG.
Nice,
she's
nice,
got help.
Nice.
Oh!
Nice.
I cannot. Oh!
What happened? Foul?
Something like that. We'll see where they place it.
Yeah, it's definitely a foul because he took the goal away.
Yeah. So 2.5 minutes to play. Breeze is picking up. Medfield with a nice little surge right there. Just a footprint away from another goal. So we
did you agree with that call?
I... yes. Hurley?
I honestly didn't see it.
It's just you go.
I think it was a matter of the stronger player got the ball.
Yeah. And a lot of times, if the goalie's trying to make for a, if you impede the goalie when she's trying to go for the ball, they call the foul.
But that was the defender who was down.
Exactly. So,
to your point, the goalie that gets the call.
Since we're up by two goals, I'm not going to stretch that. I'm not going to argue that point. Free kick from Millis. Medfield at the top of the 18.
Oh,
defended nicely by.
Oh, great first touch by KG. Nice job.
KG looking to squeak it through to Sherman. Not happening. Now Sophia Wiemet comes up. Murawski right there looking to help out on D.
Right, but I mean, look at all the middies. I mean, yep. She had nowhere to go. The middle place had nowhere to go.
So a lot of experienced team will start playing it backwards. And then, you recharge from the back line if they have confidence in their back line.
And
Sherman, a nice touch forward. She's got a good angle. Let's see what she got. She goes for the...
Oh! Made it look easy.
Wow. Like that with a minute and a half to go. She had a good angle, brought the goalie to the near post,
and then
sucked
finish.
It far post top corner. So Sherman with number two.
Great finish.
So nicely done. So.
Didn't all your kids graduate?
So that's,
I have a younger daughter playing
good
now.
Stuff. So a minute and a half to go. Midfield up by 3-0. Sherman with two. Alana Cooney with one. That was well done.
I don't think
too many keepers could have saved that shot.
No, Taylor's a pure goal scorer.
So
she brings it to the good near, then she goes far.
And she had options on that one. I think she had a runner far post that she could have dished it off to. But it's nice to if you get on your strong side foot, you might as well let it rip, right?
Right on. But you know what it's going to be. The success of this team and all teams, it's who stay healthiest
exactly.
the longest.
Exactly.
Every year, the healthy teams seem to get
continuity
through.
Continuity.
That's right. Last year, this team had some very significant injuries. Taylor missed most of the season. Then you had KG, who missed most of the season.
Yep.
And then we lost Phipsy at the end of the season.
So Millis with a corner kick. Goes right at the top of the box.
Right through. Nice and done.
And that's it. So... Medfield with putting up three.
Three.
We like that.
We do like
Millis.
That.
So, once again, this is Medfield TV bringing us some beautiful Medfield athletics. So we'll pick up more action after halftime.
Boy. You're watching Medfield TV, community shows.
Medfield Millis under the lights, the brand new turf field. Medfield now going right to left. Millis going left to right. Medfield up 3-0. And just on cue, my cohort in crime, Mike Rimmel, said maybe a good switch would be to change goalies in that second half in this young season. And lo and behold,
I just said that because coach has been playing everyone.
And so Emma Hilvert, who's a junior, going to see some early action, gets her feet wet, as it were.
Yeah.
So great call by Mike.
You're welcome.
Mike. You must have had that wireless microphone going.
I did.
Let's see if any other switches.
Got Kasseri with the long throw here.
So Allison Petit, number 25, is going to play defense closest to us. And then we have...
throw. That's awesome.
So Maggie Hurley is playing defender right in the middle. So Kasseri seems she's going to take a little second half rest. And Grace Terry... Kasseri just took the throw, so she's not...
Nice
move. So Kasseri on defense, and then Grace Terry is defense. So defense is unchanged. And then across the midfield, we're going to have Annie Phipps, number 13. Casey Chin, number 24. Maggie McCarthy, 21, touching the ball right there. And then who else we got working the midfield? McCarthy.
You got KG.
Yep.
And then you have Phipps on the other side. She's on the far sideline, so she's hard to see.
With the leg brace, there we go. And then Cooney and Taylor Sherman up top. So if we left anybody out...
We're sorry.
We apologize.
Yeah, blame it on Ned.
You know, oh,
Nice move.
A little squirt through by Kasiri. Shuts that down.
Nice time.
Is able to corral the ball. Nice body control.
Nice play by Laura.
Long legs. Doesn't let anybody get around her. Ooh, a nice ball right to the middle, but defended nicely by KG coming back.
That's Cooney. Nice turn. Good defense.
So, good defense. A little offensive surge by Millis. So Petit with a throw in.
So you want the
She'll
stats?
Do it again. What do we got for stats, Mike?
Ooh, yeah, nice surprisingly, yeah. Shots on goal.
Yes.
Medfield, 8.
Shots on goal.
Scored 3.
That's a pretty good percentage.
That's
a
pretty
right
good percentage, yeah. And then Millis had 3 shots on goal.
Okay. Could have taken a bad turn from Medfield. Kasiri able to. Ooh, it's still in.
Ooh, that's a handball or something. It's
so
got to be something.
The ball has to go completely over the line. So Kasiri's going to get a whistle.
Yeah, that's not a big deal. That's the same as a corner, you know.
Oh, but a quick kick by, real quick by Millis. That was aces. I love that. She just came down and kicked it.
I like that too.
And just Medfield was still setting up, thinking they're going to set it up like a corner
Excuse
kick.
Me.
And she just gave it a run.
So what else we back? Yeah, you know what? It's a good game.
The game's getting in your way.
It's a good game that doesn't have a lot of whistles. And,
yes.
And this is an example. So each team had one corner kick.
Okay.
Two penalties each side.
Yep.
And two offsides against Medfield. So very few whistles.
Very good, yep. Cooney.
Which gives you, you got to give them credit because they played well.
Yep.
Well, the refs just aren't calling things. Oh, he's going to make up for it now I said that.
Well,
right?
Maybe the intensity has picked up a little.
You think?
It seems Millis is playing a little more get up and go. So
here's our first save for a new goalie.
Emma comes out, calls off Kasiri. She's going to take the punt. Let's see what we get for distance on this one. Almost to midfield. McCarthy right there.
Yep, you're right.
To defend.
You're right, Ned. They are picking it up a little bit here now.
Going to squirt through, but Kasiri's right there to head it to McCarthy. McCarthy's got help on the outside. A little heavy ball in to Casey Chin. She's can't do anything with it.
Again, it's good. Good defense.
KG working the wing there. She's going to send it through. A lot of Cooney. She's right on the verge of onside also.
All the time, yes.
All the time.
Which is great.
Is what you gotta
because that's
what, you got to keep the defense off.
Yeah.
But all the, a lot
and
of times.
Sometimes that step gets you to the goal.
Oh,
that's
it's going to come
ball
through to Sherman. Sherman looking for the
that
hat trick.
Done.
Ooh, shooting from way outside. Wow. That was quick.
Yeah, you knew as soon as Taylor got the ball. Taylor's in the zone.
So she struck it from right top at the. Didn't want to play any. Had a goalie black on her line there. So plenty of net and let it run. So hat trick
for
Sherman.
Her. Great game.
So Medfield up by 4 with 35 minutes to play.
But again, Ned, all the goals are started in the midfield.
That's midfield, yeah. And they quick transition.
Yep.
And a one-on-one opportunity with a goalie.
Right on.
So
that's right.
So so that's
even you and I could get a goal doing that once in a while, right?
Maybe you.
Wow.
Maybe not. So Medfield's next game would be Friday, so after a good start to the season.
Yeah.
See if they can keep it up on.
It's going to be interesting. They're playing home against Norton, which always gives us a good game.
Norton
they're
is surprisingly.
Tough.
They're always pesky. They're always very. Always around the ball, always quick.
And every time
not particularly skilled, but they're kind of like.
And every time you think you pull away from them scoring wise, they seem to even
like
it up.
Yeah. Terriers. They're always nipping at you.
So it's Chin.
Chin playing
it
wide
off to Phipps. That's a good ball, yeah.
So I think the mission for Medfield would to keep like each goalie have a scoreless half. That would be the game plan for the rest of the way.
Yep.
Job one, number one.
And Turley switching fields, nice play.
Finding McCarthy. KG looking to help her out. That's going to be a midfield throw.
Just shape is really good. I don't know if it's because the girls are just playing really well or Millis is getting the rest up, but the shape is awesome.
Ooh, Sherman right there with a touch, and she's got a hit number.
Wow.
But Kayla Sherman with probably 4 shots and 4 goals?
I think so.
And that was
looks good.
That was quick though. And it seems like Taylor gets it. It's 1 or 2 touches, and then I'm going to let it rip. And my options are right here. So
she's going to come
out. Very nicely done.
Smart call by Coach LaFrancesca.
Yeah, keep her healthy for the rest of the season. We don't need. So that would be
Gutherson, I think. Sophia Gutherson.
Number 2. Yep.
I'm telling you, it's the bow.
Okay, what bow am I looking at? The white bow?
With the bow in her hair.
Okay, well, obviously. So, comes to Petit. Fitz looking to turn. She's got help down the line by Cooney. Oh, Cooney runs, does the polar route. Oh, and a nice through ball from Gustafson.
She is off.
Oh!
She is off.
Boy, that had...
But great, you know, but even that's a great finish from Milan.
But that was, because the ball went, she was looking for the ball outside, the ball came inside, she still had time to get to it.
It was a beautiful play, and it was unfortunate, but just
Gustafson
a little.
Gustafson had a, you know, nice little dibbity-do, that's a good play by Gustafson, who was playing her first varsity game.
It is, that's awesome stuff, but another great finish by Cooney, though.
Cooney, it's just, hey, it's a goal in my book.
Yeah.
But it's nice, a lot of Medfield, you know, the goals they scored and the goals that didn't count, they've all been well-placed balls to the corners under the goalie. They haven't been, except from Taylor's second goal, not a lot of shots over the top, not a lot of missed opportunities. They've made the best of what they had.
Put them right on frame.
Right on frame.
Nice step up by Phipps.
So,
Chin.
She's got possession. She's looking to move forward. Yeah. She's got options. Moving around.
Good try.
Cooney could...
What I liked about Chin on that one, she kept her head up the whole time as she's going through the midfield.
Yeah, and by the time she knew Alana was outside, Alana had moved inside. So, all good stuff.
Very good.
So, a little bit of a breeze blowing towards us from the benches to the booth. Shouldn't affect much of anything. It's Petit, able to get it to McCarthy. Millis with something that quick over the top, but Emma's going to come way out.
Nice play.
Nice decision making.
Nice play.
Not to have plenty of room to give it a good kick out to midfield. Millis starting from the back line. Gustafson keeping her honest. Comes
nice
forward
touch.
To Chin.
Over and back,
so that's offsides. So you can't be in an offside position, then go back onside to be the first to touch the ball. Right, Mike?
You're right. It's one of the hardest things to get right in soccer.
It is indeed. And they've been known to blow that call, even on the world, the Olympic level, the World Cup, you know.
It's amazing.
And they can miss... hands and elbows. No handballs this.
Not yet. It's been a clean game so far.
Very clean. Millis with the throw. Switches. Medfield putting 3 on the line for some swapping. So that's good to see. Let everybody play. Oh, no, they're going to swap. And if you have players on the line, regardless if you want to throw it or not, the players have to come in once they kind of go to that midpoint.
All righty.
So we have
Cross, Petit,
okay, number 12.
And not Petit, Cross, so Numerowski
and Numerowski. Okay, so now that Numerowski is closer, I can see subtle differences between her and Gustafson.
Yes, Numerowski doesn't have a ball in her hair.
Well, and her hair fully covers the number 5.
Oh, that helps.
As opposed to Gustafson, which I can see.
Number 2.
Well,
you're right.
Not as much, but it's the subtlety.
It is.
Soccer is a game of subtlety.
It really, that's what you've taught me.
So Medfield has 28 minutes to play in the second half, up by 5, courtesy of 4 by Kayla Sherman, 1 by Alana Cooney. Had 2 goals called back, so that's a pretty big production total.
That's pretty amazing when you look at how many shots from goal.
Yeah, and kind of like quick transition goals, like right ball at midfield, ball right to a striker in the net, bang, yep. Bang, bang. So
yeah, nice and clean. And ball in the box.
Medfield traditionally, like, they'd get their goals over the set pieces, like the corner kicks, but only one corner kick. Ooh, stay in. Alana Cooney keeping that working hard.
And oh, nicely
she
done.
Is paid off for her perseverance.
Oh, great ball. Oh, good try. Yeah. Good try.
Gustafson looking for the call.
So nice turn
when,
by
it's
Sam.
It's nice when...
Here we go.
Gustafson with a touch.
Come on,
see if she can... She's got...
Good play by the defender.
She's got the speed, but I don't think she's got the jets that her sister does.
No, but we haven't seen that. Okay. We haven't done yet. Christina could just leave
the
10 yards. Yeah.
What did she run? The 100 in track?
It was she was incredible.
She was a blazing fast.
Nice as can be. Yeah. As far as personality.
KG playing far.
Nice. That's good to see, yeah.
Millis, the keeper. Comes to midfield. McCarthy staying upright. She gets tripped after the fact, but we're not going to call that
nice.
One.
Nice, lost the whistle.
And just squeaked Kasiri. Dumps it off to the wing to Grace Terry. Stays on it. Nice flat pass to Sophia. That's Sophia, correct?
It is.
Sophia, we met.
We're sending Moroski. Nice touch.
Our older sister played last year. Graduated last year.
No, she's been out a couple years.
Yeah, they're all.
She actually graduated from college last year, so she's been out a long.
Okay.
Great soccer player.
Alana Cooney. Going to get the benefit of that. No, won't get the benefit of that. Millis throw down the line. Sarah Cross.
Well, this is good. We get to see this up close here. Most of it's on the other side of the
field. I think maybe they tilted the turf.
It's
this
nice.
Side
I know. It's
action.
Very nice that they thought of us. Here's one mid on the throw-in.
So she can give it some distance. So
good throw.
Right towards... McCarthy yeah. Looking for a little head flick to kind of skin it off the top of her head and go far post. They'll work on that.
Here we go.
Goes over the top, but Kasiri recovers. And
that's a good try.
The safe thing, as they say, when in doubt, kick it out.
That was a good run by Millis.
Yep. Kasiri's going to let this one run. She's going to shield nicely.
Ooh.
Yeah, it was all the way out. So you don't need to touch the ball when it's going over the end line. As long as you're running towards the ball, you can slow down.
That is key.
As long as you keep moving in the direction, if you come to a dead stop, you're going to get a whistle.
That is key, because if you do stop, you're blocking. And
you're blocking.
It's going to be bad.
My therapist would say you're blocking.
Really? Is this something new you want to talk about?
Not lately. So it's going wide. Grace Terry and KG trying to make something happen for Medfield. Breeze has picked up.
Oh, it's a beautiful
night.
Gotta
keep our notes.
What a beautiful night.
Would you call this a summer evening or a...
Yeah, it's just beautiful. Before you know, we'll be playing in the cold rain.
The cold rain.
Senior night, right? Isn't that how quick it goes?
But we'll be in the sanctuary here, the booth, the Medfield.
That's right.
The resplendent Medfield broadcast booth.
Okay, what do we got here?
Millis.
Corner
kick. So Medfield putting Grace Terry near post.
So this is the
Someone
second
on
of the game for
post,
them.
Which is always good. Kasiri right.
So where are they going to go here? We got a short ball?
Runners. Comes right to the top of the goal box. Kind of squirts through. No harm done.
I'm not sure how you're supposed to score when you bunch all your plays in one spot.
Yeah.
because then you bring your defenders all to one spot. I don't understand that one.
But
and
really,
it's like, and they had one person free, but she was playing deep.
Yep.
So it's like, how is that going to score?
Well, a lot of it has to go with the pace you put on the corner kick. You really got to give it some speed.
Right, but to my point, there was no one. There was no one open.
No one there. Maybe. Yeah.
And Medfield just packed the box and.
So that's.
Nice turn.
Murawski turning.
Crofts. God bless you.
So 22 minutes left to play, second half. Medfield 5, Millis 0. Ooh. That's going to get scooped up by Emma Hilvert, junior goalie, getting some second half action. Played well. I don't think Sarah was tested with that one play in the first half. Made
Sarah,
a good decision.
Yeah.
And Emma has made some good choices so far.
Nice Cooney, nice Cody. Touch.
Oh, she's got room to work with. Looking to
scoop
it through to OKG, who gets obstructed just a little bit. But,
great ball. That was a great ball from Aluna. Cooney.
So the top line, we have Cooney and
Gustafson
on the far side. And technically, Numerowski on the near side.
They're
kind of like the three offensive striker types. We met in McCarthy and center midfield with Chin. Grace Terry on any Phipps. KG's on the far side still.
Yes. In fact, she just got caught on that foul. So.
And then Terry Kasiri and Sarah Cross on defense. Free kick from Millis into the midfield zone. A little flick over. That's going to run out for a midfield throw.
Yeah, good hustle by Crofts.
Crofts getting some, sneaking up the line there. She got 8 yards. We like that. Millis with a little bit of a slow touch there and couldn't make a decision. So
Kathy.
Nothing happened. Cooney. Numerowski right there. So Millis looking to dump it over the top. McCarthy's going to play it to Numerowski, who flips it to the middle.
KG touch,
KG, but Millis with three in the zone. Medfield with three. Nice steal by KG. Gustafson, stays in the play there. Flips over the top. Cross. Heads it down. Millis almost took advantage of that.
Oh, because I was just going to comment, they haven't had numbers because of the middies all getting back.
Yeah.
Like on that play before that one, there were six midfield defenders and there were two Millis playing ball.
That's exactly.
And it's like, it's not going to happen. But that's one of the few times they actually had equal numbers. Because it is about numbers.
It is about numbers. You can't, you got to have. It's when you've got the ball, it's nice to have at least three options of what to do with it. Play inside, play outside, play over the top or something like that.
Yep.
At the very least, play back. So if you're up there on an island by yourself,
not going to happen.
Nothing's going to happen. So Millis with a change. So halfway through the second half, 20 minutes to play, Medfield 5, Millis 0. Well, home opener.
Season coach has got to be happy with the way the girls have played. Held their space beautifully.
Yep.
I mean, that
confident
to me
building,
has been throughout the game.
It's nice to see some of these, like Numerowski getting some minutes and Gustafson getting some minutes because.
You're going to have those games.
Defense, when you play defense, it's pretty standard. Yeah. And you know who your partners are. Offense, you really have to be on the same page with your linesmen, your midfielders and your thing. So it's good to see that they've had some good chemistry early and often. So who's taking that throw, Mike?
Is that Petit?
Watch is in there. That's Gustafson. Squeaks out. So is Petit once again?
I have
on the
no idea.
Side?
It's too far away. It could be Womack.
It's too far away.
I'm getting old.
That's what happens when you see you play a par three. You say, it's too far away.
It's too far away.
Can we
drive there?
I'm going to take on the cars.
Can we drive there,
So
please?
What do we have? We have corner kick.
It looks like
field.
A corner kick, yep.
Okay, so far post. So that would be... Who's taking that?
I have absolutely no idea.
Okay, but we have... Ooh,
good
nice
ball.
Red across. Oh, wow.
That was easy.
That was over the goalie's, over the first defender's head. And so Sophia Wiemet, looks like she was able to knock that in, if I'm not mistaken.
It was McCarthy. And 21. I'm waiting for the person. Chin did the corner. Took the corner.
I think you're correct. Yep.
Great. Corner kick. I mean, Mike, that went in all by itself.
Yep.
That's an awesome one.
She had the wind behind her back. So,
awesome kick.
So, Medfield up by six now. So, yeah. McCarthy.
Yeah.
From Chin.
That was a beautiful kick by Chin.
Had some pace right
there. It just sailed nicely, once the goalie, off
3 yards off the line.
Yeah, that was a goalie's ball, but she just didn't get there.
So set piece, Cooney. Just dancing around and waiting for something to open up.
Nicely
and it does.
Done.
Finds KG on the sideline. Numerowski's right there, but Millis able to clip it out. So what are we getting, a goal every 8 minutes? A goal every 7 minutes?
It's been spaced. So nice. Nicely done. All quality goals, too.
All quality, no real easy ones.
A
little bit of this. It's nice to see to get something from the corner out of...
Absolutely.
How many corners? Two corners? Three corners?
Oh.
Where's that?
That was the third corner.
Perfect.
Yeah.
That's a good ratio.
Yeah, I'll take it.
It's a deep throw. Is that...
Yes, we're met.
It clips in.
Work with me on this one.
I will. Yeah.
Yeah, I think it is Sophia.
Yeah.
Oh, there's another one. She takes the throws, right?
When Petit's on this side, she'll go in and take the deep throws. So corner kick. So Casey Chin once again. Medfield massing up
is
to the top
again?
Of the tin. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, mm-hmm. Low line drive. Comes
sitting
to
in,
almost got
in,
to a Cooney's foot.
Nice play for
playing it forward.
He crafts. Nice play. I'm not sure what that's about. Obstruction? No?
I was looking at other things.
I think it was obstruction, but that's a 6-0 call. Well, did
right.
I say that out loud?
Say no. Say what? So Millis with a free kick right over midfield. Medfield stacking the D at the 20. And
nice
Millis
ball
able to almost dump it over the top. Emma's going to come up and pick that up.
Yep, good play.
So, I always thought they had back in the day, you could always take 3 steps without bouncing the ball. And it seems you can just pick it up and run with it as much as you like. I noticed that when I was watching the Olympics. The goalies could pick it up and just run around. They didn't have to bounce it. But back in the old days, you couldn't take more than 3 steps without doing something with
it. See, when I played, we didn't have to do that.
You didn't have to do any. What was that? Oh, almost. Oh, Millis with a chance. Had
nice
a run
play by Kasari. And it's Cooney.
Can't keep it in. Oh, well, the ref did four.
That was nice, that yeah. Count.
It's the ref. He's part of the field,
he
right?
is.
So. Millis, nobody home. Oh. Good call. You can hear Emma calling way up here that she's going to take possession.
We must be nice downwind of coach because I can hear him. I can hear him on the calls.
Yeah, yeah.
He hasn't lost any of his intensity.
Yeah, well, it's even with a 6-0 bubble, there's always a coaching moment.
That's right.
Another call from Millis. Midfield backing up. So last time they were at the 20 and she put it over the top. So they're going to do the same thing right now. They're going to bump it. It's going to go
right there.
Okay,
but where's she going to go?
Well, it's going to go right there. There you go. Yeah. No harm, no foul.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I guess on a more of a set play, maybe do something
else. Why don't you just set it up and play it wide? Because that's, you really don't take a you know, it's like a kickoff.
Right.
You don't kick it right down the field.
Yeah.
You pass it around. So that's experience. So Emma getting a lot of action.
It's good. Good to see.
Just picking it up, working on her her punts.
Good ball.
I think the goalie should have a contest. You know, they try to drop it into the blue.
I think that's that's a great target to aim for. Yeah.
And they get a helmet star every time they. Cooney, makes it around. She's got.
Did everything right.
So Cooney has scored one, hit the post once, correct?
She's actually scored one that counted, scored one that was offside,
and then hit the post.
And then hit the post, yeah. So she's
That's not a bad day at the office.
She's had a great day.
So
the whole team has had a great day. Coach is going to be very pleased with this one.
Yep. Weather is nice.
I can't wait for us to beat DS in Medway this year.
Absolutely.
It's always good leaving DS for the win.
McCarthy, she's got to take something long range. Oh,
nice save by the keeper.
Those long range shots when they take a little hop right before the goalie are hard to handle. Big moon ball.
That's a chin.
There's a ball over
there. That's
a
nice
top.
Ball,
we'll
yeah.
See what
Terry
can do with that one, Terry.
Ooh, oh, great step by Kasseri.
Nice redundant defense there, helping Grace Terry. That's
defense. The D has just been helping out. I mean, very, very well.
And good awareness on, Millis cut to the inside.
Yes.
And so Kasseri was there to help out. So we have 11 minutes, 42 seconds. Medfield up by
six. Wow.
So
Terry came out.
Maggie Hurley came in. Is that 20 or chin?
No.
Okay, Hurley's got the headband, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, she's easy to spot.
She is, yeah. Kasseri heading it forward to McCarthy. McCarthy's playing it wide to Numerowski. And that's going to go clipped out harmlessly.
Kerwin, that was Kerwin who came in.
Ah, ha, ha. Thank you.
Yeah, Neil Kerwin. She was on the team last year as well. Matter of fact, most of these, I think all of them returning players, except for Gustafson, correct?
Yeah, because it's tough to be a returning player when you're a freshman, right?
It is, but you know, if someone could do it, Gustafson could figure that one out.
So Kasseri coming back.
Helping out, yep. Take it, Lauren. Get it out.
Playing to the outside, which is a wise
move. Nice play, you're right, Ned. That's Kerwin.
Goes down, but that's going to be a goal kick for
corner.
Goal kick.
Corner.
Goal kick. Clearly kicked out by Millis.
Clearly. you could see that all the way over there. Go. Come on.
Yes, 10 minutes to go.
I find that hard to believe, Eric.
That's right. So, goal kick for Medfield. Clearly, goal kick comes to
Matt. Everyone saw except for me. Kerwin, yeah.
KG.
No, didn't quite get there.
McCarthy.
Again, I'm really enjoying the five across on the midfield.
It just seems to be working. Well, it's a quick
onside. Onside.
Yes. Cooney in. A heavy touch, but she's still heavy. Wow. Add that heavy touch.
Yeah,
and got in between.
That is good stuff.
And the ball got a little choppy on her.
Yeah.
But
she lost her angle.
She had
great play.
Good intention though. So,
great feet. Great ball.
Feet. Yeah, exactly.
Again, it came up through the midfield.
Yep.
So is that
good stuff?
Cooney going out.
Well, Cooney's just getting a little
giving a little respite. Yeah, coach is saying, put that one in next time, will you please?
Yeah.
And it's Fipsy.
She had a good game. That was but it's funny how you know, not that I've ever, the strikers, all of a sudden, you're in by yourself there. It's, you got to think quick. And you've got just a little bit to see what's going on. And
yeah,
she's done well.
I don't think I've ever seen so many forwards
through
in a row.
Yeah,
in a game, mean, it could be really 9-0, 10-0.
But usually when you play a team that knows it's not going to score a lot and is really not very good, they tend to pull everybody back defensively.
Right.
And so you have to go through the trees, a lot of trees to get a
But that's so
goal.
That's not that what they're doing here.
Yeah,
they're just
and
trying to...
And Millis is just, they're playing like their standard defense, and they're not, you know, bringing everybody back to make it kind of muddle up the area.
You're absolutely right. That's normally what happens.
As you like a Bellingham, they usually just, they play like six defenders.
Yeah, Bellingham, Westwood.
And you gotta work through it, and you get some kind of choppy, ugly, sloppy goals.
Yeah.
But you get them, but... Millis is playing, you know, a standard defense, and Medfield's making some nice through balls and runs because they're running out of the ball from 30 yards out.
They are.
Yeah. So it's a quick transition.
Yeah. It's going to be interesting to watch this season, how the team progresses,
you know,
against better teams, maybe different formations.
Yep.
Right.
Yep. And, well, it's nice that everybody on the bench has played, except for, unfortunately, injured Sydney Jolene.
Yeah. And hopefully, Sydney will get back in a hurry.
And
I don't know, she's got an elbow injury. I wonder how long that's
affecting her penmanship. You know,
you never know.
These kids, they have to do a lot, or her typing skills on her.
There you go.
Oh,
who's this? It's Gustafson.
Gustafson.
Oh.
In there alone.
Oh,
so,
thank you very much.
So let me get that. The Millis goalie had it, then she put it down, and Gustafson sniped it from her. That's what it looked like.
She won't do that again.
And
Millis goalie,
you know, understandably upset with kind of a brain freeze on that one. But Gustafson, with a smart play, you just, you know, you run after the ball. Just don't take anything for granted.
Good for Sophia.
If the ball is on the floor, go after it. So that'll be a fun one to see.
I'm gonna watch for that one.
So
I'm not really sure how the goalie gave up that one up.
Well, I've seen
when I looked up, it was too late already.
I've seen some like YouTube videos of some professional soccers where they had a player behind the goalie, and the goalie forgot he was there, and the goalie put it down to, you know. Because you sometimes goalies can kick it by and they can punt it, and the guy sneaked right behind them.
Oh, I like that. That's kind of like the first baseman in baseball, holding the ball.
The hit and ball trick, yeah. Ooh, there's a heavy hit. Crafts, but
I'll
be able to take care of it. So
Sophia's off.
Gustafson coming off.
And Graham.
Sarah Graham. That's what...
that's
the good
awesome.
Old days, playing
Ooh,
in the
that's
field.
A foul, but I'm not going to call it.
And
that's awesome.
That's... why not, you know? When was the last time she played out in the field?
I don't know. That's a
well,
good question.
Remember back in the day when Mimi Borkin used to come out of goal?
Yeah.
And they'd play her in the field, and the same thing with...
That one's fine.
With the gnarly girl, and they come out on corner kicks and get a reward for doing so well in goal. So 5 minutes to play. Medfield up by a touchdown. Haven't heard
that's,
that.
That's just crazy.
7-0.
It's crazy. You know, and coach, he's played the bench, so he's not. He hasn't been.
Nobody got hurt, which is always a bonus.
Not yet. So let's just get through this one.
Millis throw.
Nice play by Womet.
Moving through the midfield. Comes to McCarthy. McCarthy has...
Oh, you get it to Grammy.
Options.
That's the Phipps. Well, you got to let Millis. They haven't stopped playing. They're still playing hard.
Here we go. Ooh, inside out.
Nice play by Cross.
Cross over to clear that
up. There's Grammy. I'm glad she didn't use her hands.
She's got it. Well, I'm going to take that. Oh, a nice touch and turn.
And Murawski. Come on, they gotta hustle. Come on, Sarah. Come on.
I can do that.
Good try. Ooh.
So, 4 minutes to play. McCarthy and Cross closing on that ball. Comes over to Wimet. Millis looking to squeak it through, but can't make through the far side. To Kerwin. So Medfield trying to hold on to that.
So this formation's much more into a short passing game, which the girls have done well with.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, instead of the kickball, and they're going to play teams who played a kickball, but this wasn't the case tonight. So it was very controlled. The girls
kept their
shape beautifully.
Get it from the back line to the midfield quickly.
Yes.
And the midfield makes decisions quickly.
And it's quick touches, which has been very successful.
The only thing that's worked against Millis is their defense has always pulled up to about the 35. And they've kind of played right into midfield. Oh, nice running back by Kasiri.
See, that's a corner, but that's a very good point because they've scored 7 goals and Medfield's been offside 4 times.
Yep, so exactly.
Yeah,
so.
At the end of the day, your point
but
is...
Most teams, they'll pull up their defense as far as they can and get them over midfield like they are right now.
Mm-hmm.
So Millis is not playing like, they're playing a good brand of soccer. You know, unfortunately, they're on the wrong end of the scoreboard. That's a knockdown, so that's going to be an advantage. Millis right there top of the penalty area.
Yeah, it's Maggie.
We'll see what they can do with this with 2.5 minutes left to go. So.
And again, I didn't think that was a penalty as much as the stronger person with the ball.
Well, you knock him from behind.
Yeah, she was running through it.
So let's see how they set this up defensively. 10 yards back. So the refs don't have the shaving cream like the pros. I like the shaving cream.
I do too. That's cool. It's easier on a football field, then. Do you know that?
Exactly.
You taught me that one.
So 10 yards back.
Where do you aim? Just pick a corner?
She's going to go. Ooh. Oh, it's trouble.
Right there.
It gets scrummed around.
But they had a chance.
I kind of like that play. You know?
What, trying to chip it over?
Chip it over. If you don't have a clear, if you don't have a sniper that can put a top corner, just kind of chum it in there.
Did the goal even touch the ball?
No. But
so you say to yourself, you're on an 18. How does the goalie not even touch the ball?
But they had it was scary.
It was a good play.
I was afraid. I thought bad things were going to happen.
Nice passing again. Great distribution.
Phipps has had the lucky number 13 of her whole career. Comes out to KG back in.
Yes. Good call.
Well, it's easy with the knee braces.
Yeah, that's true, too.
I can get the certain visual cues I'm very good at. The easy ones. Comes back to Kasiri.
Oh. That was Graham.
Graham trying to
nicely
make something
done.
Out of nothing.
Very nice. Stay
comes
on, Sam.
Phipps. Oops.
Come on, Sam.
Murawski.
Great shot. Oh.
Wow.
Great ball. Great ball.
Left-footed. Goalie didn't expect it.
Oh, Sam has a great left foot. Boy, I remember her in Summer League a few years ago.
So... Sam, another legacy player, her sister Christine, played 7 years ago.
Yeah, went to Skidmore.
So
great soccer career there. Awesome
sure, like,
player.
Clint spent the summer learning some tricks.
He's a good ball.
Sarah Cross. Oh, keeper's keeping away.
Nicely done.
Oh, no.
Can't be much time left here. I didn't see the foul.
I think Abby played the ball, and Emma hit the player.
Oh, Emma took the player.
And Emma hit the player. So if it was vice versa, because Emma kicked it out, and Emma was coming forward, and she, her momentum carried her through. So
okay, so we
top
should,
of the box there.
Yeah, I would go near post
if
I'm kicking.
Near and low.
No. Got to get through the wall to do that.
Yeah.
It's McCarthy.
So we're under the magical 2-minute mark.
It's got to be almost over now.
Clock's a ticking. McCarthy's going to kick it towards the Millis bench. It's going to roll out. Millis has a very small population.
They do. Yeah, low numbers.
Low numbers. So Because I know when they play football, you know, football they do a Tri-Valley large, Tri-Valley small.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Isn't that how it works, Eric? So Millis is in the Tri-Valley small because their numbers are not what Medfield is. McCarthy able to shield. She's got to pull out field. And
there you go.
The double whistle. So Medfield closing out the season opener.
7-0.
A good
good start.
Good start all the way around.
Kind of
so,
like that.
We'd like to thank Eric Assell and Medfield TV for
Thank you, Eric.
Coming out here and making this possible. I hope you enjoyed the broadcast. This is Ned Hackett and Mike Remo.
Thank you, Ned.
Join us again next time. Bingo. Let's talk about politics.
I'm going to get something to eat. I'm starving.
Really? Yeah. I had some.